Understand what we are talking. We are actually trying to understand friction on and reaction together. Friction and reaction together. So for that purpose, we have taken an example in which I have taken a mass M, and the force F is acting on the mass. And when the motion will happen in this direction, then automatically we are considering the surface is having friction. So because of that, between the both the surfaces, like bottom surface of the block and the top surface of the road, will be having molecular attraction. Because of that, will be having friction force in this direction. So that friction force F, in last class we saw that your F is nothing but mu into R, right? What is R here? What is R here? Yeah. How much? How much? Yes, right, you're right now. So this R is actually nothing but the reaction force. And where the reaction force is acting? The reaction force will act like this. And in last class I told you that this reaction force has to be perpendicular to the surface. Perpendicular. So you can see it is perpendicular to the surface, right? Now because of that, we say that our R value is nothing but, right now, mass, if you multiply with the g, it will be, the total thing will be a force, that is nothing but the weight of the block, right? So this R is equal to weight of the block, that is nothing but mg. So this mg I can replace here. So my friction force formula will be mu into mg. But now, as in the last class I explained, this mu can hold the value mu k or mu s or mu l. Okay, so because already the block is in motion, already the block is in motion, so it means kinetic, mu k. So this mu we will replace as mu k. So we got our friction force. Now understand, here total forces in the direction of motion, parallel or anti-parallel. So how many forces we have? So this force F is acting in this direction, and this friction force F is acting in this direction. So the force F minus friction force will give you a resultant force, that you can say your mass of the object into the acceleration of the object, right? So of course, if the mass is moving in this direction, so it will be having certain acceleration because it is having resultant force on this. So this force is the applied force, this force is the friction force. So they both will tackle each other and will be having certain amount of resultant force. So this force is responsible to accelerate the block with a acceleration. Okay, so now this F we can replace with this. Okay, in that you will write F is equal to, sorry, F minus mu k m into g is equal to m into a, and you can rearrange this, and whatever is there you can find out that. So this will be your first idea when we combine our friction and reaction in case of linear motion. Now if I want to combine this question then with the pseudo force, concept of pseudo force, then I will add and pseudo force. So now I will explain an example in which the same system, we will assume another system on this, and we will explain the idea about pseudo force. Okay, so now let's understand what is pseudo force in the next page.